Hi everyone, Dr. Steph. I'm back here with a video talking about the top 15 things that we find clinically in our practice that are needing to be addressed and handled in order to help people reverse their type 2 diabetes. I'm going to combine another couple today. One is going to be thyroid and mitochondrial dysfunction. So very quickly, the thyroid is a gland in the front of the throat, and it creates a hormone called thyroid hormone. I have done a lot of series videos on this you can check out on our YouTube channel as far as thyroid metabolism and things that impact thyroid. But one of the things that we know is that the thyroid, one of its main purposes in secreting thyroid hormone is that every single cell in the body requires thyroid hormone uptake in order to run its metabolic processes. So the thyroid essentially is a master gland that dictates how well you are running your processes. And that means how efficient are you at burning fuel. So if your thyroid is not functioning very well, you're gonna kind of be like lethargic and tired and slow and constipated and nothing's really happening very fast. And as a result, what we see is blood glucose comes up because you're not metabolically very efficient at burning it. Cholesterol builds up. One of the things that we find clinically as a very common cause of high cholesterol is low functioning thyroid. So do you really need a statin, or do you really just need to get that thyroid functioning and get that metabolism perked back up again? Mitochondrial dysfunction. This is at a cellular level what runs our metabolisms. So every cell has these little tiny organelles, these little things that float around inside of them. One is the nucleus, that's the center of the cell, where all of your DNA is produced. But then you have these other little guys that float around, and they're called the mitochondria. Okay, at one point it's theorized that these were independent bacteria that got into the cell, and we now have incorporated that into our function. But they're extremely, extremely important because mitochondria, the health of the mitochondria determines how old or young you're going to be, how long you're going to live, how short you're going to live, but it determines also your ability to manufacture proteins and energy, in particular ATP. And we take glucose into our mitochondria, we take fat breakdowns and protein breakdowns into the mitochondria, and we actually burn them. So they're kind of like our cell engines or our cell furnaces, and we burn these things down into a fuel that our cells can actually use. And so if you have mitochondrial dysfunction, and there are several things that we need to assess for why you might have mitochondrial dysfunction, it might be infections, it might be toxins, it might be hormone imbalances, it might be vitamin and nutrient deficiencies, it might be chronic stress. There's all these things are kind of interconnected, as you can see. But if you have mitochondrial dysfunction, there's certain things that need to be done to get your mitochondria back on track so that you can get your body efficiently burning fuel again, which means that you're going to be better at maintaining normal blood levels of glucose. So mitochondrial dysfunction is something that has to be checked and addressed for, and as well as thyroid dysfunction. We need to see, because both of those things are very important as far as cellular metabolism goes and efficiency of burning fuel. So I hope again that you found this helpful. I hope you understand the complexity of this disease. It's not just a simple matter of don't eat sugar, switch to the diet products. You're not going to reverse your diabetes if you've had it for a long time without really digging deep into some of these other underlying issues. So stay tuned for some of our upcoming videos. We're going to complete the series of the top 15 things that we find clinically with our diabetics that need to be addressed.